Hey guys, and welcome to Demons of Promatic 2. Wait a second, doesn't this room look familiar to you? Isn't this from a game called Tremor Season? I'm not sure. What I'm sure of though is that these scrolls are autosave scrolls. When you pick one of them, the game will autosave. So there's no autosave being forced on you, like in TNT, which is a good thing. You're showing the difficulty rooms there? It's kinda nice. We're playing as the Ultra Valence equivalent, of course. That goes without question. And this lava down there is only insta-kill lava of the whole game. And if you go bare this portal, you get into nightmare mode, but we don't want to do that. So let's get started instead. And here we are, on the first map, Hell Above Water. This map starts pretty hard for just our first map, there's a lot of tough enemies. And difficulties overall is a little hard. Very far from Hellraiser 2 or Alien Vendetta hard. But it's challenging. Some moves are pretty tricky and knowing where the secrets are really helps. We get the super shotgun very early there. Which is a good thing. Because I don't fight all these guys with a normal shotgun. It'll be boring. It'll take forever. The difficulty of this map is controversial because the fact that there are autosave spots. Even if you forget to save yourself, you can pick up these scrolls whenever you want. So dying is not much of a problem because they are well placed. The next room is kinda tricky. So there's only two ways to properly do it. I mean, two good ways. First one is to go into this room. I just got in front. Or you just rush there and keep the silent control and stay in this corner until everyone is dead. You can stay in the middle, you'll be attacked from all sides. If you panic and don't know where to go, you're definitely going to die. There's Tyrannotrons, Geckos, there's a monkey bar on the side. Everything is against you. Tyrannotrons this early in the mod is kinda brutal. But I like it. Like I said, the difficulty is pretty challenging, but it's well balanced. Like you get enough ammo, health, weapons. And if you find secrets, the game isn't wild in Ultra Valence. One thing to note though, this game uses 3D floors, like this bridge right there. What that means is you can play this mod on software under like Z-Doom or Skulltag in software. You have to use GZ-Doom. Not sure if you can play it on Skulltag with OpenGL. Didn't write it. Secrets are too bad to find, like right there, you can see this plasma cell there, you can't get to it, so obviously that means there's a secret behind. A few secrets aren't that obvious, but they aren't too badly placed. So it's not too bad. When walking down there, a few revenants spawn where you were before, so you have to watch out, I mean, listen for them if they come behind or not. Hopefully for me they didn't come. This trap might seem unfair, but it's actually not. If you just keep shooting and don't panic, you should be fine. The red and whites are stuck in each other and they want to shoot at you and thus they don't move toward you and make you stuck at the end of that corridor or something. Just keep shooting. If you do the other way and just run straight down there, kicking these guys up there are going to be very tricky because you don't have a rocket launcher. So I'm going to do it the way I've done it. So there's more insight and yeah, overall it's more fun. I like the level of details too in these maps. It looks good. I mean, nice use of textures, of forms, not being over detailed like Tormentor 667 maps. Or Knee-Deep Zendo that we'll be seeing later. The amount of enemies is also pretty good. I mean, there's a good balance between in-scan enemies and non-in-scan enemies. Something like TNT, which is in Final Doom, where there's so much chain gunners everywhere. It's so bad. So annoying. It's good to have a pretty good mix of enemies, seeing a good variety of them. You don't see these automatons too often, most wars. Except in very hard wars like, you know, Air Revealed and stuff. This part is a pretty fun one. Instead of fighting all these guys up there, the Revenants, Geckos, you just rush through. Open this nice secret there and get this enormity. I should have used a plasma gun to get out there, but I'm doing fine. And then you just take this pretty awesome rocket launcher right there. And this is extremely fun. Look at this. What you want to do is kill the Revenants and make sure there's nothing behind there, so you can then finish them without being attacked from the back. Kikademons can go through the barriers there, which is a very good thing. That reminds me of the Enormity in the Demonocratic 1, the last map. Not the last one, but the one before that. There was no real use for it. You would find it, but there wasn't any good spot, place to go with it. Here, make some good use of it, you have some good fun, and everyone is happy. There's also a Berserk there, but you really don't need it since you already have a super shotgun and yeah, you almost have every weapon already. No spoilers, you don't find the BFG in this mode again. There's no barrels either. Which again is a good change from usual mods where there's always a BFG hidden somewhere and there's plenty of barrels doing... I don't know what to say doing there, but they're still there. This part is a little tricky, you have no cover and you have guys shooting from the side and these Gecko demons going toward you. Again, don't panic, dodge incoming fire and shoot at them until they die, like usual. Twenty floors again, you can see on this bridge, which are not possible on normal Doom mapping. You can do it with another technique, but it looks very bad. I like 3D4s, they're good. One thing too about this, the music usage reminds me of Half-Life 1 music usage. I mean, there's a lot of music that was like somewhat calm and happened when you entered a certain areas, which was kind of cool and ambient. And same thing in Half-Life in this mod, when at some points we'll be seeing more, I mean, less ambient music at some events, at some encounters. Like the first time you encounter Marines in Half-Life 1, there's some more, to say it, some more moving music or something. Is that really true again? And it makes it kind of obvious there's a secret up there, so you just ump the walls and away. What's this? Again, the difficulty isn't too hard if you know where the secrets are, because you get plenty of free stuff. Like the plasma gun, mega, not mega elf, soul sphere, ammo, and this kind of stuff. It's very helpful. It's kind of the same thing for most WoWs. If you play in hard difficulties, finding secrets is almost vital to your survival. Nothing can operate skill though. This trap right there can be a little non-obvious the first time. You would think that this switch opens the door, but no, it opens this, and by the time you notice this panel mounter there, but they have thrown like 5 or 6 of these rod swords at you, which can be kind of troublesome. Nothing critical, but it's very annoying. In this part, I make a few mistakes not going with better weapon right off the bat. So I should just use the rocket launcher or the plasma gun. You have to keep some rockets for the right next part though, which is kinda funny. As you can hear, beyond this world there's a lot of imps. You know what that means? That means it's Gibbs time. Glorious. Using a rocket launcher never was so any fun, I guess. This actually though can be a little pain in the ass. If you didn't find the secret plasma gun, hopefully there's one right there. Just for this use. And before going to the next part, I'm going to go back and get a secret I left there. It's not too hard to find, you can see it without too much trouble. You have to go into this non-stucky lava. Oh, hey. I wish you respawn somewhere up here, because there's no way to fall into the lava when you're on this level. And that's the last part of the level? There's two ways. You can go down this elevator, or you can take the secret back door, which gives you two nice goodies. An invisibility sphere and a radiation suit. I actually don't like the invisibility sphere. I find it very useless or even counterproductive. But in this place, where there's a lot of people firing on you from the side, it's pretty helpful. Helps you getting it less, and you don't have to care that much about dodging stuff from all sides. That might play against you, like usual, but a little less since enemies are quite far. It's much more effective than fighting enemies that are just in front of you. And swimming in lava feels so good. So good again after playing UTNT. Well, just touching the lava with the bottom of your feet just instant kills you. So we're seeing the ending of this level. I'll be seeing you next time.